Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Before you start blasting me in the comments section, yes, I did take down my TikTok. No, it won't be going back up. It's for personal reasons, and just to inform you, everything is okay. It's as okay as it can get. I should have said that. So today, we're going to be doing a what if. I know I sound really angry, and I am, but it's whatever. There's nothing I can do about it, and nothing I want to do about it. It's not anyone's fault. I'm just a moron, okay? Well, so let's get that out of the way first. Let me fix this. Alright, good. Alright, we're good. All's well. So, today we're going to be doing what if Deku had Joker. They may be wondering, Red, well, if he has what's Joker, or Red, why is John on the cover? People who have read on Ordinary are like, my boy, you's a genius. And to the people who do think that, thank you. It's greatly appreciated that you think I'm a genius, because a lot of people don't. A lot of people hate my ideas, but what you gonna do? Also, I turned 16, like, 2 days ago. Yeah. Also, my PS4 is being stupid, so I'm not going to be able to broadcast anything. I was going to download Subnautica, Subnauseous, and play it, but it is what it is. Anyway. Okay. So the way I'm going to do this is when Izuku is born, you know. Also, I'm going to change Hisashi's quirk. See, his quirk is going to be like a really weak copying quirk. So, basically what's going to happen is Izuku and all his parents are going to be affected by the One For All fight. What I mean is, the One For All and All For One fight, you know, All Might versus All For One, round one, you know, square up, boom, boom, boom. Izuku's quirk is a really weak version of his father's, mixed with his mother's. Basically, he can hardly copy someone's ability, although that's going to change. So when, you know, All Might and All For One first squared up, and I was like, pow, 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 Izuku was exposed to the powers of All For One and One For All. Now, the way his quirk works is similar to John's from Unordinary. He can see aura and then use his to copy it. Even though Izuku's aura is really weak, the moment Izuku came into he didn't even mean to. His aura went into contact with One For All and All For One. He started sucking out energy. Now, if you didn't know, which you probably do, All For One is going to enhance his copying ability, making his aura stronger and making his ability stronger by being able to sense aura, like John can. The boosting part is from One For All, because One For All boosts quirks, which self-explanatory if you've seen the show. Now, this also means that the sense ability, his sensing ability, is going to be jacked up. He's also going to have, you know, a permanent strength boost. And the amount of, okay, John has in the Unordinary universe, John has a limit to how many abilities he can copy and boost. And he can't copy abilities where he can't see the aura. Now, I'm taking these restrictions away. He is going to have a limit to how many quirks he can have. I mean, quirks abilities, I'm just going to consider them the same thing. A limit to how many he can copy and amplify. But the thing is, if he has multiple weak strength enhancers, he can fuse them together and then boost it, creating a whole new quirk or ability. So, I mean, cut me some slack here. I'm giving him really cool abilities. Now, there is going to be a telltale sign when he activates his ability, because his eyes go from green to orange. You know, they glow orange, like John's. So, getting actually into the story, and I'm done with explaining his abilities. Now, time skip, you know, it's been a few years. Izuku. Oh, yeah, Serafina is going to be here, along with Arlo. And, like, two other. No. Pretty much the entire, you know, kings and queen. King, queen, ace, you know, all of them. All of them. So, what I mean is, Arlo, Aizen, Rei, Serafina. What's the red? Oh, Blake. I was about to say, what's the redhead dude's name? It's Blake. I just remembered. Anyway, I'm gonna turn on the AC so there's less echo and drown out some of the noise so I'm actually able to talk. So when Izuku was little, you know, the same thing happened. Not really the same thing happened. I mean, Izuku, you know, finally stood up to Bakugo. You know, Bakugo tried to throw an explosion. Izuku, who has, may I remind you, his body has a permanent, you know, strength, durability, stamina, and speed buff. Strength, speed, durability, and endurance buff. Basically, he's able to tank young Bakugo explosions with little pain. Now, the reason I say little Bakugo explosions is because Bakugo is a kid at this point. He's like 7 and maybe 8. His explosions are gonna be a lot weaker than they are in actual canon. Well, where he is now in canon. So, yeah. So after this, Midoriya copies his ability, you know, and then he's like, "Take this!" Boom! Nabakugo is resistant to his own explosives, but that one did hurt, and it sent him flying. And he's like, "Oh, that's numbness, numb. Ooh, pins and needles, pins and needles." You know, he starts shaking his hand. And Nabakugo's goons are getting up. You know, they're like, "Square up, bro." Also, he can't copy mutation quirks. That is a limitation. But Kirishima's quirk, he can copy. Quirks that allow the body to transform. Kind of like, you know, Sero. You know who Sero is? Not the tape dude, but, you know, guy eats sugar. Super buff. Yeah, him. He can copy abilities like that. He can also the quirks after, or abilities that he copies them afterward, you know, if they're like emitter abilities like Black Whip, explosions, half hot, half cold, etc., etc. Heck, if he copies Aoyama, I think his name is Aoyama. Yeah, if he copies Aoyama's ability, like, why would you do that anyway? The beam would be orange and black. But Blake, Serafina, and all the other five big characters are going to be here. He's about to be so freaking buffed. Okay. Also, it is canon, that is now canon. After, you know, this happened, Izuku gets sent away, and he has to, you know, he's told not to use his quirk, to seem like he's quirkless. If he doesn't, he's gonna go to jail. Now, you may be wondering, dude, that's freaking stupid. That's stupid. It's a t-day, isn't it? I'm sorry, I had to. Anyway, so basically, where was I? Oh yeah, Serafina, you know, Izuku has to seem quirkless, so he gets beat up a lot. He and Serafina worked on a project together, yada yada yada. Basically, you know, while they were in middle school, I'm gonna need a pack of smileys. Izuku and Serafina and Arlo and all of them, you know, became semi-friends, I guess? Like friends, Arlo and Izuku are like frenemies because Arlo, you know, doesn't like Izuku. Aizen found out that Izuku does have a quirk, and Arlo forced Aizen to tell. No, Aizen forced. No, wait. Oh God, Arlo forced Aizen to figure out if Izuku had any secrets he could use against him to get Serafina because he likes Serafina. Aizen found out about Izuku's omegally powerful quirk. Now, another thing. Remember how I said he sucked out the abilities for, you know, energy out of one all for one and one for all? Guess what happens if he runs into them? Yep. If he runs into All Might, you know, his time limit drastically starts decreasing because his, you know, energy is like a parasite. It will suck out the energy because it's got a taste and now it can't get enough. Now, same goes for All For One. But Izuku can't, you know, copy One For All or All For One. Can't happen. The reason is One For All, you know, is One For All. Unless the user is willing to give it up, they can't take it, or copy it, in Izuku's case. But he can suck the energy out. Now, I'm not saying it'll destroy the quirk, but it'll weaken it. Once it gets to a certain point, the user won't be able to use the abilities until it has time to recharge. And for All For One, there's just too many quirks. You know, he can absorb the energy from the quirks, but he can't copy them all. Because if you have, okay, let's just say he runs into a Venomu, you know, in the story, he'd be able to copy both the quirks, but it would take a lot of, it would put a lot of strain on his body. See, if the person has more than one quirk, it's harder to copy the aura, if that makes any sense. So, you know, Arlo forced Aizen to tell him about his quirk, and, you know, Arlo's like, oh, alright, square up. You know, Izuku's like, huh? Come on, you know I'm quirkless. I wouldn't last a minute. He's like, no. Fight me. Oh, hello, I'm making a video. I'm sorry. I cleaned the golden room like, oh, I forgot to pick this up over here. Oh, fun. Oh, anyway. Now, getting back into the video. So, again, you know, Arlo's like, no, you have a quirk. You know, Izuku's like, what do you mean? You know, I'm quirkless. He's like, you know, in his head, he's like, Arlo, shut up, please. You said you want me to go get the babies up? Oh. Okay, I'm gonna go. Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you bring back food? Thank you. Hey! Hey! The babies! What are you doing? I'm gonna go get Duke. Ooh, give me love. Give me love. I'm gonna come get you. Anyway. Getting back to the video. When Midoriya... you know, finally decided to, you know, Arlo placed a barrier around Izuku and started condensing it. You know, Seraphina is like, Arlo, let him go! You know, and Arlo's like, back. You know, he creates like a secondary barrier, I guess, to capture Seraphina. Which this barrier is a lot stronger because Arlo, you know, has been training. So he weakened the barrier around Izuku and made the barrier around Seraphina stronger. You know, Izuku yells, let her go! Let her go, Arlo! Okay, I'll turn it on. You know, he's like, make me. He's like, you know, Izuku gets up and he's trying to punch through the thing. You know, his knuckles are getting bruised. You know, this barrier is a lot weaker than that, huh? What are you looking for?
My keys.
Oh, your keys. Do you remember where you put them? That way. Midoriya, you know, since this barrier is weaker, Midoriya, with his minimal strength enhancement, is able to break through it. You know, Arlo's like, he didn't even activate it. Huh? I locked the back door. Oh. Okay. Sorry. So anyway, Midoriya, you know, is like, he starts running over to Arlo. So Arlo had to drop the barrier around Seraphina to defend himself. So when Izuku slammed his fists in Arlo's barrier, it, like, really hurt him. He's like, ugh! Ugh! Ow! Yep, that hurt! Ugh. He looks at his wrist. Okay, that's broken. That's no fun. You know, he jumps back. He's like, leave us alone. Come on, Arlo. I know you don't like me, but that's no reason to hurt Seraphina. You know, Seraphina runs over and she uses her ability, Rewind, you know, her ability to manipulate with time to rewind Izuku's arm to, his body to before he started punching at the barrier and broke the weaker one and then punched Arlo's barrier at full strength. He's like, thanks, Seraphina. I really appreciate it. He's like, Blake. You know, Blake starts shooting lasers at Izuku, and he's like, Arlo, what are you doing? You know, no, Seraphina's like, Arlo, stop. He's quirkless. Leave him alone. There's no reason for this. He's like, come on. Arlo, please. You know, Seraphina's like, Arlo, stop. He's quirkless. He can't defend himself. You know, Izuku's like, Seraphina, no, I can't open the door. I can't. I'm Thawi. Anyway, Izuku's like, Seraphina, get out of here. I'll get out of here as soon as you do. She's like, no, you run. I'll keep Arlo distracted. He's like, no time, go. She's like, fine, but if you get hurt, I'm kicking your butt. Don't hit me. He's like, I'll be fine. You know, Izuku starts walking over to Arlo, dodging the lasers before, you know, as Blake fires him, right the split second before he's, you know, they hit Izuku, he dodges and then gets back into place. You know, it looks like the laser just went through him. You know, he starts walking closer and closer to Arlo. Arlo, sweat drop. He's like, so, you finally activated your quirk. It's not on. I wear something to make sure it never comes on. You know, as he, right as his, you know, he lowered, you know, he starts taking off his, whatchamacallit, his tie? If you know what I mean. Hush! You know, revealing a collar. You know, if I do... That's gross. You know, right as Midoriya pops the collar. After that, you know, the collar just... You know, all of Izuku's power just explodes outward. You know, he's just, no. Seraphina didn't, he didn't tell Seraphina to run away. He's like, Seraphina, back up. I'm sorry for lying to you. But I was told not to use my quirk. You know, and then he loosens up the bow tie. You know, Seraphina's like, why? Because last time I used it, and not only nearly killed me, but it about destroyed my old school. You know, Arlo, everyone else in the area gasped. As Izuku pulled down his tie, you know, as everyone sees the collar around Izuku's neck, this thing prevents me from activating it at full power. So right now I only have about 2%, which is my enhancement ability. How I was able to... Now. An immediate... What? It's okay. You know, Midoriya is like, I swore I wouldn't do this, but, you know, he slides his finger under the collar, you know, starts pulling it. As energy starts, you know, everyone can see this, you know, all of the unordinary characters can see the energy because their quirks are pretty similar. They can all, you know, see the aura of people. Kinda. You know, some people with quirks can see it, some others can't. You know, as Midoriya's about to pop the collar, you know, orange and black energy starts emanating off of him as he rips it off. It just... all of the energy, all at once. He's like, oh, man. Feels like I was stuck in a cage for years. Ugh, this feels good to release it. Feels good to let loose. You know, he's like, so, bring it! You know, he starts smiling as he then dashes towards Arlo. Now, Midoriya has copied a few quirks here and there. Mainly, you know, he's able to copy quirks that he's seen before, or is seeing. You know, he sees Arlo's barrier, copies it, and then as he's running towards Arlo, right before he hits, he creates a barrier around Arlo's barrier and is like, gotcha! You know, and then he starts making it shrink as Arlo is forced to make his barrier expand. Now, Izuku is amplified this ability. So it's about 4 to 5 times more difficult than it should be. You know, it's like... it's a 5 times multiplier. Now, if he gets one for all, which I'm gonna leave up to y'all, it will be a 20 times multiplier. So it would be like 4 times stronger. So. Boom! Remember, with the weakening ability, you know, the weakening thing that Arlo was affected with, he even admitted that, you know. You know, he's like, ugh, my barrier couldn't withstand the force of a car. I mean, this man's barrier is OP. You know, right as he sees Blake's ability, you know, and Aizen activates his, starting to charge towards Izuku. Also, if you didn't know, Aizen's ability is Hunter. I actually find it really cool because he's able to see heartbeats. This man just is like, oh, dark side lasers. Everyone's like, what? What is dark side? Who's dark side? You know, as he starts creating, you know, 10 orbs appear on his fingers. As he starts blasting all of them at once, you know, he's only targeted Aizen, Blake, and Arlo. As, you know, two of the lasers hit those two, but they're in non-lethal state. Also, he's like, just to let everyone here know. You know, as he's saying this, his face is like covered in black, and orange eyes are the only thing that appears. My quirk is called Joker. I'm a wild card. You know, he's like, I'm the wild card. You know, as the things hit, most of them, you know, two of them hit Blake and Aizen. You know, knocking them out. As the other eight go straight for Arlo, shattering his barrier. And hitting him, knocking him out. You know, Seraphina's like, Izuku, you have such a cool quirk. Why'd you hide it? Because I was told I'd be in really deep trouble if I, you know, activated it and hurt someone too bad. The last time I turned it on, I nearly killed a lot of people. It was an accident. I was so small back then, I had literally zero control. After that fight that I saw, my power got a lot stronger. You know, as he starts releasing a lot, you know, he starts releasing energy that's, you know. Also, you know, he drops Arlo's barrier ability because, I mean, it's good for defense, but the area and the time it takes. Like, wait, never mind. He doesn't drop Arlo's ability. He boosts Arlo's ability to make it to where he can create armor. Not, like, actual armor, but, you know, like a second layer that's nearly... That quite literally is nearly indestructible. Like, this man could probably tank a freaking... You know, a gigantic... You know, this man could probably take... This guy could probably take... multiple rocket shots from quite literally any rocket. Like, it's hilarious how much damage this thing could take when he activates it. Now, Izuku's lasers that he activates, they can, you know, change direction depending on if Izuku wants them or not. Or you can just let Hunter do it. Now, Hunter, if you didn't know, allows him to see people's heartbeats and stuff, but it also boosts. It's like a really big explosive boost to his strength, speed, durability, and endurance. It gives him the properties of a hunter. Kind of like Predator, but it's kind of like Predators, but, you know, quite powerful. So Izuku immediately is like, bring it on! You know, Rem is like, Izuku, what's going on? You know, Seraphina, Izuku, what happened? You know, Serafina's like, Izuku does have a quirk. You know, and then Izuku explains how his quirk works. You know, Aizen is the first one to wake up like, yep, as expected of the Joker. Come on, there's no need to call me that, Aizen. We're so cool. You were forced to do it, weren't you? Yeah. All right, then. It's not your fault. You know, Izuku they fist bump. As Midoriya then... Midoriya then, you know, both are girl, you know, Rem is like, wait, you can copy other people's quirks? Well, yeah. Actually, if you activate your ability, I can copy it. As long as it's an activatable ability and not a mutation ability, if you know what I mean. I can't copy mutation quirks. You know, they're both like, huh. So you can't copy that guy over there. You know, as they point to a guy with coat hanger, pretty much, it's that one dude from the first... Hush! From the first episode, you know, the guy that's like, so kids, you wanna be a... Hush! So kids, you wanna be a hero? Yeah, basically that guy. And he's like, nope, can't copy him. Although I can copy some transformation quirks. He's like, huh. They're like, huh. So if someone had the ability to turn their skin into stone, you'd be able to copy it? Well, yeah, it's the transformation quirk. I can copy most of them, but some of them I can't. The real difference is kind of hard to tell. Emitter quirks, I can copy pretty much any emitter quirk. As long as their user uses it first. I can see it. Right as Rem's like, sweet, if I activate my lightning ability, yep, I'd be able to copy it. You know, she turns on her lightning ability, he's like, okay, you sure you want me to do this? Because it's going to be a lot stronger. No, they're like, huh? Well, with my ability, I've been copying very small versions of y'all's ability, you know, people's abilities. I've seen people's quirks that are a lot weaker than Seraphina's, you know, Arlo's and all them. Everyone else's. I can use smaller quirks to make, you know, smaller strength abilities to fuse to make bigger abilities. To make mid-tier abilities. And I have another ability that allows me to boost them to make them high-tier. I can also infuse low tiers into a high-tier to make it stronger, then boost the high-tier to make it god-level. No, I can use low tier and mid tier to make strong abilities into near god tier level and then boost it to god tier level. So they're like, huh. So if you copied Seraphina's ability and used, you know, the quirks, any abilities you've copied and sacrificed them, you can make Seraphina's ability even stronger? Yeah. I can make it fast forward time, actually makes me allow me to travel through time, completely freeze time to where no one can perceive what's going on. Reverse time for someone to make them go back so far they literally turn into a fetus. I would probably be able to create portals too. And do a bunch of other stuff. Okay, copy our abilities. See what you can do with them. You know, Izuku copies Rem's ability and Seraphina's ability, and, you know, he starts, you know, releasing a lot of lightning. He's like, oh, cool, I just thought of something, hold on. You know, he raises both of his hands into the air as the lightning energy, you know, the lightning appears around him. You know, he starts changing the freaking weather. This man is changing the weather. He's crazy. He's a mad lad. Mad lad town. And then, you know, he brings his hands down, creating a massive bolt of... I'm talking like this thing would encompass the Nomu 10 times over. And whiff. Like, it would take 10 Nomus just to go from one side to the other. To fill it, that'd be like a lot more. Like, a lot more. And it's just pure black, and on the outside, it's just emitting orange. Now, the moment it hits the ground, you know, I'm just gonna say they were on cement. The cement turns to glass. Yes, that is the amount of heat and energy he just emitted. And when rocks are flung, they're not rocks. They're glass. That is how hot the lightning is. And how much voltage would be pretty much impossible to measure. Like, if you can tell me in the comments how much energy that would require, I'll give you a cookie. I'll like your comment. I will like your comment and be like, dang, bro, okay. Anyway. You know, Seraphina, you know, everyone who's watching, jaw just hit the freaking ground. You know, Seraphina's like, ooh, do mine. He's like, okay, let's see. I could probably, you know, he touches the ground. Now, he does have an area to where he can rewind if he touches something. Like, if he touches the ground, he can only rewind things in that radius. He can decide how big the radius is, but the maximum he can do right now, just acquiring Seraphina's ability, not really using it, is like 15 meters. He touches the ground, he's like, rewind! You know, then he turns his hand to the left. As all the rocks start flowing back towards the center and turning back into cement, he's like, good as new! You know, Seraphina is like, I can't even do that! What? He's like, yeah, check this out. No, he creates a really big powered laser in his left hand and blasts his right hand off. And everyone's like, "Holy crap, Izuku! Whoa, 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 wait, check this out." No, he grabs his right shoulder and is like, "Rewind." As all the atoms get pulled back together, recreating his arm. As Midoriya starts, he freezes time and he's like, "Wait, check this out, check this out." He freezes time, walks. Also, he does have super speed because of the hunter quirk, the hunter ability he copied, and some other speed quirks and strength quirks, and he has a lot of he's super smart. He uses his super speed to get over to this. He goes to New York! Yep! I mean, it wouldn't be too hard, especially considering you wouldn't be able to fall through the water because, hey, no, back. Get down from there. Thank you. He wouldn't be able to fall through because of not being able, the water not being able to move out of the way because time is frozen. Midoriya gets over to the Statue of Liberty, he takes a picture, and then he runs back. They're like, he unfreezes time once he gets back, and they're like, "Wait, how long was time frozen?" "About 3 hours." "You can freeze time?" Seraphine's like, "Wait, you can freeze time for that long? I can only freeze it for about 10 minutes before I start getting tired." Unless one of the others is around, they're at each other's throats, quite literally. Like, it'll take a twig snapping and they'll start fighting until one is not able to anymore, and Izuku normally wins. "No, I can't sit there. There's bad things on over here." Like, it's hilarious. Okay, shush. Oh, my poor legs. They hurt so bad. No shush. Anyway, Midoriya then says, this is after Izuku and Arlo just got done fighting. Izuku sits down like, "Dang. Your barriers are getting stronger. Too bad mine are like 3 times more, like 4 or 5 times more powerful." Arlo's like, "Won't be like that for much longer." Anyway, this is pretty much part zero, so I'm gonna end it here. I don't know how long this video is.